degrees of summer make me think all the world is just a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera. I love to take a photograph, so mama don't take my Kodachrome away. If you took all the girls I knew when I was single, everything looks worse in black and white. Kodachrome, they give us those nice bright colors, give us the greens of summer, makes you think all the world's just a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera. I love to take a photograph, so mama don't take my Kodachrome away.
Here are the chords that are needed. This song is played with a capo on the second fret, so these chord names are in reference to open position chord shapes. You'll need a D, a G, an E minor, an A7, a D7, a B7, an E, an A minor, a C, and a B minor. Let's take a look at the chords on the guitar. Here's my capo on the second fret. So you'll need a D, a G, E minor, A7, D7, a B7, an E, an A minor, a C, and a B minor. Let's look at the bass notes of that riff that's on G. It sounds like... the bass notes on that riff are 3rd fret, 6th string, 1 and 2 on the 5th string, open 4th string, 1 then 2 on the 5th string again, down to the 3rd fret of the 6th string. 1st and 2nd frets again on the 5th string, open 4th string before you do the little walk down before you get to the E minor. So that walk down is 3rd fret, 2nd fret, 1st fret of the 6th string, and then you go into the E minor. The riff in the most basic form is just the bass notes. But you can add the rhythm to that without much more effort. And it'll sound like this, played slowly. What I'm doing there is I'm hitting that 3rd fret note and then hitting 2nd and 3rd strings open. And that's the first step. The second step is 1st fret 5th string and then 2nd fret 5th string, and then coupled with the 2nd and 3rd strings open. So it sounds like... and the 3rd step is the open 4th string followed by 2nd and 3rd strings open. And then the next step is the same as the 2nd step. So you do 1st fret, 2nd fret with the open strings again. And then finally you go down to the 3rd fret, open strings. So it sounds really slowly like... and then at the end, once you get to that open 4th string note, right after that, you're gonna go a little walk down to the E minor. So the whole pattern played slowly sounds like this. tablature for the riff on the G chord. The lines are the strings of the guitar, and the numbers on them are the frets that are played. There are two guitars that make up the intro of the song. I'll play both parts of the guitar and explain what they're doing. The first guitar does this. What's happening on that first guitar is you're holding a D shape, and I'm hitting the fourth string, and then first and second strings. And I'm hitting them twice, so it's bass note, two high notes. And then I hit second fret, fifth string, and then second and third strings open. So it's... The second guitar in the intro does not feature a capo and plays this. What I'm doing there is I'm making a little E-shape chord, but I'm focused on strings 1, which is on the 7th fret, and strings 4 and 2, which are on the 9th fret. What I'm doing there is I'm plucking 6th string, 2nd string, 4th string, and then the 1st string. So it's like... And that repeats. There's a little variation you can throw in on the line that goes... I know they'd never match my sweet imagination. What that variation is you start off with the D, and go down quickly to a D major 7, which is just barring the 2nd fret here on strings 1, 2, and 3. And then down to the D7. So it's like, they never match my sweet imagination. And then to the G riff. The ending of the song is the chords G, B minor, E minor. Twice. And what I'm doing there to begin the picking is I'm starting off with the bass, hitting the middle strings, and then hitting the high note. So it's like...